In our variable climate, as our population increases and industries change, competition for Australia's precious water resources intensifies. To ensure we have enough water for everyone, it is important to account for how water is managed across Australia. We need to know how much water is available, where it is, and how it's being used. The Bureau of Meteorology's National Water Account provides an annual picture of water availability. It plays a critical role in the planning and decision-making processes of governments and industry. To create the account, the Bureau collects and analyses data from more than 40 organisations for 9 key regions around Australia. Together, these regions are home to about 80% of Australia's population and represent around 70 to 80% of Australia's water use. Each regional report covers water availability, sources, trading and use. The 2014 account covers a 1-year period from 1st of July 2013 to 30th of June 2014. During that time, we saw relatively dry conditions across much of Australia, particularly across the east. Below average rainfall in most of the eastern regions led to a decrease in storage inflows, with the impact greatest in the Murray-Darling Basin region, where storage volumes decreased from 69% to 57% during the year. The Adelaide, Perth and Orwood regions fared better, with near to above average rainfalls. Storage volumes in these regions increased during the year, particularly in the Orwood region where storages were 100% full. National water use dropped by 21% compared to the previous year. This is mainly due to a large decrease in water use in the Murray-Darling Basin, reflecting the low water storage and drier conditions across the region. All other regions except for Adelaide reported increased water use. While surface water remained the largest source of water used across Australia, groundwater was also a big part of the picture. Surface water accounted for 84% of all water used, while groundwater accounted for almost 15%. In the Daly and Perth regions, groundwater accounts for more than 2/3 of total water supply, as surface water is less reliable. If we just look at urban areas, we see that alternative water sources, such as desalinated water, are used to meet 10% of current urban demand around the country. Adelaide and Perth rely on desalinated water for almost 40% of urban supply. Both regions have increased desalinated water production over the last 3 years, which is helping to conserve surface water stores and ensure water security is not reliant on rainfall into the future. So in summary, a second consecutive year of dry conditions across much of Australia has meant inflows to storages were down in 2013-14. In the Murray-Darling Basin, water allocations and water use decreased in line with the reduced water availability. But storage levels leave reserves for next year. You can find more details on each of the 9 regions at our website, bom.gov.au/water/NWA. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Dean Mollier.